on a Friday night yet.
Released as a submission to the Ludum Dare Game Jam back in November 2020, Friday Night Funkin' is a free-to-play rhythm game with a colourful style reminiscent of flash games of the early 2000s, and really bopping tunes to get you to hit every note to the beat. From rapping on a stage to being sucked into a video game, all for you to impress your girl, there's a large variety of twists and styles to be impressed by, from the presentation to even the music. And that's only an understatement for the game that requires only the arrow keys. And maybe being good at rhythm games is enough a requirement. Being developed by four cool dudes of Newgrounds.com, that being Ninja Muffin, Phantom Arcade, Kawaii Sprite, and Evil Skater, the squad has set themselves out to make the best damn game ever, with heavy inspiration of games across the early 2000s, like the aforementioned Flash games, and even PlayStation games of that era, with Parappa the Rapper being the biggest direct inspiration for the title, alongside pulling in other games of his genre, like Dance Dance Revolution and Guitar Hero. With their powers and inspirations combined, they pushed themselves on to make what you all know as Friday Night Funkin'. And did they hit it big? Long story short, why the f*** do I need to tell you? With 24 million views on Newgrounds at the time I'm writing the script, with dozens upon dozens upon dozens of videos being uploaded to YouTube like every single day, yeah, it's safe to say they hit it big. They went further beyond expectations for a rhythm game from things. But what gave this tiny title such massive exposure and rise to gaming stardom? Well, today, we're going to talk about the aspects behind Friday Night Funkin' and what makes it different and special towards folks across the internet. Let's start off with the basic information. It's a rhythm game that's free to play. And that's already two factors which can get people interested. The game being free to play allows anyone to have access to it. Simple enough, really. But on top of it being a rhythm game, anyone within that circle of interest has the chance to easily try it out. From people who want to hone their skills, to professionals who want to be challenged by some new beats on the scene, or to online creators who claim that the game gave them RSI. Yeah, be sure to exercise those finger muscles before going into this. Next up, style. This game just reeks of it. In a good way, of course. From the style of its art design and to even its music, there is just no end to different ways the game pulls it off and makes it mold together so well. As previously mentioned, the artistic choice in presentation and overall aesthetic is reminiscent of flash games of the early 2000s, but what makes this stronger in its appeal is the phasing out of what was popular way back then. Let me explain. Back in late 2020 and into early 2021, Adobe decided to kill off the Flash Player platform due to security issues and their transitioning into other platforms and software, with developments over the years allowing more flexibility across a multitude of platforms and devices. And while this was announced back in 2017, so people had the chance to bring their projects to more accessible and safe formats, it unfortunately meant the end of an era for early and even current styles of games and animation made in Flash. Especially on websites that was filled to the brim of it, most notably Newgrounds, which was home to the most influential animations and games that were made using Flash. What the hell does this have to do with Friday Night Funkin'? A lot of things, actually. The game's artists have their own styles that are definitely reminiscent of the early 2000s flair of what Newgrounds and Flash content was back then, and the two styles really complemented each other well in my opinion. Hell, I just look at their stuff and just think they were around the early days of Newgrounds. But they've only been around since 2014. If that's something they tried to pull off, then they did it perfectly. Because I and many others get a strong sense of nostalgia just by looking at the game's aesthetic, just being reminded of what kind of early barren wasteland the internet was back then. Furthermore, this sense of nostalgia is hit right back at people, with the inclusion of crossover characters like Skid and Pump, Pico, and even Tankman. But that's something I'll talk more on later. But enough rambling about that. The music. Honestly, can I just say it bangs? That's all I can really say, like, listen to this. From hip-hop to techno, from fast to slow, each theme from the menu to the actual gameplay moments, they just somehow fit. Of course, there's obvious thematic tracks with certain sections of the game like Halloween, Christmas, and being inside a video game, but a lot of the time there's just a mix and mash of different genres that somehow just mesh together well, and they make each track unique. But take what I'm saying here with a grain of salt, I know very little about music theory. And to me, that makes me want to get every note correct, and even if I miss a few notes, I'm having a blast just listening to these tracks. They honestly rock. The composer Kawaii Sprite really hit it out of the park with this soundtrack, and the game ain't even done. Please, go listen to the soundtracks on Spotify and so on if you haven't already. Oh, and yeah, be sure to stream Chucky Finster. Although, if I were to mention more on the music, going back to the Flash nostalgia, it kind of gives me those vibes, with the music being funky, upbeat, and downright addicting, which is maybe enough reason as to why we were so enticed to these games back then. Eh, probably. But going off the sense of nostalgia and the general vibes of the game, let's talk about our wonderful cast of characters. Of course, we have our three staple characters here, that being the boyfriend, girlfriend, and a dad. Each of these three designs have something so simple, yet effective, to how they convey their personality and attitude from the style, expressions, and even the animations. Boyfriend has got that sharp but soft look with the exaggerated swagger of a skater boy, with his cool, cocky confidence while he stands and sings to win the heart of his girl. Speaking of which, let's talk about her. While only being in the background of the songs, she still shows expressions of emotion, from cheering in the back from successful no-hits in the tutorial, to crying from unsuccessful no-hits during a combo. Even the smaller details like being scared by thunder and just not caring when she's held at gunpoint, waving her hands in the air like she just don't care. And that's not all, even the dad has got style and expression to his design. With his dark-toned rockstar fit, contrasting with the boyfriend's style of light to dark, protagonist to antagonist, it's simply conveyed but done so well. Or maybe not, maybe I'm just analysing them too much. But even so, with the other characters, they too have really well done designs to make them iconic and recognisable, in knowing who they are and what attitude they display, from their design to their animations. And speaking of recognisable, there's three characters I need to obviously show off, because it brings back to the sense of nostalgia, and even the remembrance of the early Newgrounds days. And yes, I'm referring to Pico and Tankman. Not Skid and Pump, but I will still involve them as they are still crossover characters. Skid and Pump, known as the Spooky Kids, are a pair of Halloween-inspired characters designed by the artist Senor Palo, as part of his animated series of videos, Spooky Month, with this aspect of crossover being more apparent when the tracks of the week they appear in having Palo himself being mixed into the vocals when the pair sing, which is even more fitting when he does the voices for the characters in the animations. Next, Pico and Tankman, which I'll focus on more due to their relevance to Newgrounds, because it is strong. Pico is very close to the culture around Newgrounds, originally appearing in Pico School, a Flash game from 1999, created by Newgrounds founder Tom Fulp. While being simple by today's standards, and also very controversial by today's standards, at the time the game was very impressive, being made in Flash 3 before the availability of any variables. Despite this, Pico and his coinciding game was iconic, as he eventually grew to become the site's mascot, eventually getting a site-wide event of Pico Day, which started out as a day to celebrate Pico and Tom Fulp's birthday, eventually turning into an event to celebrate Newgrounds as a whole. Pico's appearance is close to Boyfriend's, sharp as poof with his known bright attire. And a gun, of course. Next up, Tankman. And like Pico, Tankman is also very close as he's directly the site's icon. You know, the tank and all. He then became his own character when the animated series Tankman was made, being animated and voiced by Johnny Uta, becoming an instant hit and cult classic to the site. His appearance in the game is relatively close to his original bold design, while still being expressive in his animations, including the special ones. His speak is also incredibly faithful to the Tankman series, from the landscape to the smaller details. And of course, the blunt humor.
Pretty tight bars for a little dude who's simping over an ugly, boring little teenager that wears her mom's clothes.
It's aspects like these to the characters that really hit deep with nostalgia, and it brings itself together as one big love letter to Newgrounds with something new and fresh, but impactful and rememberable, and that's something really hard to hate on. While it may not be something people can easily relate to, and especially myself as it's not something I strongly grew up with, It somehow connected with me, and I'm thankful for it, especially with week 7, but all of this love is put together into something amazing. With the voice acting, animation, references, jokes, it's almost like the golden age never left, especially with the finer details of blood and vulgar language.
Ah, look who it is, your sexually ambiguous, angry little friend. Don't you have a school to shoot up? There's one way to settle this. Let's rock, you little cunt. You little cunt.
And with all of this put together into a solid package, it's one giant collection of great art, music, and good times. And to some, it's like an internet time capsule. And the game isn't even finished. They've still got a ton of weeks left to finish with many characters, tracks, and settings to show off, on top of everything else offered through the Kickstarter. And to think that ain't impactful enough, the Kickstarter quickly smashed its initial goal of $60,000, and is already over $1 million in support, which is incredible. If you like the game or just want to see these guys do more of it, I implore you to support them in any way you can. They've already put so much work into this to bring it out to everyone for free. And with this support, they can honestly make, to quote themselves, the best damn game possible. But that is not all. There is one aspect, which is a massive positive to what makes Friday Night Funkin' so special. While it may be free for you to download with an option to donate to them directly, the game is also open source. This means the game is a free, open box for anyone to mess around with, in any capacity. And because of this and the game's rising recognition, the modding scene is huge. Mod after mod, big or small, people from all over the different places of the internet have come to make something for the game. Recolors, character swaps, custom songs, new mechanics, entire new weeks, reworked functions. From experienced individuals to beginner level users, anyone can take a shot at making something for this game. Hell, it's so simple, I was able to make something. With mods upon mods releasing every day in high numbers, I simply cannot give it justice in this video. If that's something you all want me to cover, please let me know because I'd love to talk about it. What the community has given us has honestly been great, and I would totally recommend you to check out some mods that people have made. And that's what I think makes Friday Night Funkin' so great. Over the 6 or 7 months of the game's release, it somehow perfectly crafted itself to be a really nifty, intriguing but flashy rhythm game that calls back to a time where the style reigned supreme across the web, bringing resurgence to the independence of aspiring game developers, bringing resurgence to Newgrounds, and bringing the classic days back into the spotlight, bringing in so many people across the internet into the spotlight to share their creative aspirations. And it's honestly a sight to behold. You can like or dislike the game for all the reasons you want, but you cannot deny the impact surrounding it. Many thanks to the supporters on Ko-Fi who help me continue to do this type of content. This time I would like to give a special thanks to Bellyman with a £10 donation, commenting, "It really wouldn't let me donate one penny," and to Conga Line with a £3 donation, commenting, "Am I SST yet? Congrats on 100 Ko-Fis.